In this video, I am going to explain mechanics of median nerve injury. This is median nerve. It is from brachial plexus. It passes medial part of humerus, and it passes anterior part of elbow, anterior part of forearm, and it goes all the way down to tips of finger. I will explain three places that median nerve injury most likely happen. Let's go to first place. First place is around anterior part of elbow. By the way, this is median nerve. Median nerve. First place is about here. I shall talk about this muscle first. This is pronator teres. Pronator teres. This is pronation of wrist. Pronation is your palm goes down. That is pronation. So, pronator teres can be tight because of too much use of pronation, too much usage of this muscle, or supination is tight. Supination is the other movement. Supination is your palm goes forward. Your palm faces front. That's supination. So it's like flipping movement of wrist. So if you use a lot of wrist movement, maybe median nerve gets impingement around pronator teres. By the way, median nerve kind of goes deep to pronator teres around this area. It kind of dives into pronator teres. Does it make sense? These two structures are very close to each other. Thus, too much use of pronator teres may create impingement around that muscle. Next muscle is this one. This is flexor digitorum superficialis. Flexor digitorum superficialis. This muscle flexes your finger. Do you remember? I said median nerve goes deep to pronator teres, and also this nerve goes deep to flexor digitorum superficialis. Imagine, if you use too much movement of finger, this muscle gets shortened, this nerve gets tight. Then what's going to happen to median nerve? There's chance for impingement. So these two muscles are important for median nerve dysfunction around anterior part of elbow. What happens if median nerve gets impingement? What kind of muscles get dysfunction? That may be pronator teres. Yeah, of course. Pronator teres may get dysfunction. Of course, flexor digitorum superficialis, and maybe for muscles around thinner eminence. Thinner eminence is a bulk part of base of thumb. That is called thinner eminence. Pronator teres, flexor digitorum superficialis, and muscles around thinner eminence. This is number one. So let's go to next place. Next place is kind of close to first place. By the way, this is first place. It's around pronator teres, right? And flexor digitorum superficialis is removed. This is median nerve. It's deep to these two muscles. There is branch from median nerve, like this. This nerve is part of median nerve. This is anterior interosseous nerve. Anterior interosseous nerve. This nerve can be damaged because of flexor digitorum superficialis and maybe pronator teres. Pronator pronator teres again and flex the digitorum superficialis. So what happens if this part gets impingement? Maybe other muscles can be affected, such as flexor pollicis longus. Flexor digitorum profundus. And so on. Flexor pollicis longus. Pollicis means the thumb. Again, when median nerve gets impingement, flexor muscles and thumb muscles are affected. This is number two. Nervous tissues around deep to forearm. Let's go to next place. Next area is right here. It's around carpal tunnel. Carpal tunnel is very famous area. If this part gets impingement, what's gonna happen? It's gonna be carpal tunnel syndrome. It's very famous place and the disease. This median nerve. What kind of tissues aggravate nerve around here? That can be retinaculum of wrist. Retinaculum is like a wristband connective tissue right here, and maybe other flexor muscles. Flexor muscles of wrist and flexor muscles of fingers. This is very busy area. Many tendons, many connective tissues are around carpal tunnel. And of course, there is median nerve. Too much usage of these flexor muscles may create impingement around carpal tunnel. Then what's going to happen? Carpal tunnel syndrome. What kind of activity creates tight flexor tendons? It may be occupational movement, such as carpenter, such as typing. Then, athletic activity may create tightness here. Maybe tennis, maybe baseball, maybe badminton. Sports which you require a lot of finger movements and wrist movement. Thus, median nerve injury is very common among people who use elbow movement, wrist movement, and finger movements. Let's go back to the first place. It's around here. It's anterior part of elbow. Then, what's this muscle? This is pronator teres. Do you remember? Pronation and supination is wrist flipping movement. Now, occupational movements such as carpenter, hairdresser, or athletic activity may damage these muscles and nervous tissues. See? Upper extremity movements, elbow movement, wrist movements, finger movements creates tension for muscles, tendons, and median nerve. I hope this video gives idea for understanding median nerve dysfunction. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.